If I remember correctly, this is an indoor air quality sensor released by Ikea in 2023. The price is $49.99 and is currently available in stores. This device has a Zigbee module, so it can be linked to other devices by connecting to the Ikea hub. So what I wanted to do was to create this UI design using LVGL. Not only that, I wanted to create a device that runs very similarly by connecting an environmental sensor. This is my version of the indoor air quality sensor. The ESP32 used here is my favorite WT32SC01 Plus. I have worked on a lot of projects with this device so far. I'm pretty sure you know what it is. To obtain data such as temperature, humidity, PM, and VOC, multiple sensors must be connected, like one from a temperature sensor, one from a PM sensor, and something like that. Rather than that, I was wondering if I couldn't get all this data from a single sensor, so I looked for this sensor module. Since this is an all-in-one sensor for the surrounding environment, I was able to obtain the data I needed with this single sensor. This is pretty cool. I will talk about this sensor again in the next video. Now, let me show you how I worked on the UI part. Here is the source code for this project. What I want to check first is the graphics library. In the previous projects, I used TFT ESPi. However, since I will be using the WT32SG1 Plus in this project, I will use the Lovyang GFX library as it has the best performance in this device. Usually, the graphics libraries are similar in use, but they are different in how they are set up. To use Lovyang GFX, you need to configure it according to your display, like the usual setup of TFT ESPi. The setting is for WT32SG1 Plus, so it must be changed for your device. If Lovyang GFX supports your device with auto detection, it can be used without the need for such settings. Please check Lovyang GFX documentation for more detail. Now let's take a look at how the UI is drawn. This source code can also be found on my GitHub. As always, we started by creating a basic screen object first. The basic style created above sets the border, padding, and default radius to 0 and sets the background color to transparent. This completes a blank screen. Below is the image at the top of the screen. This is an image I drew while looking at the actual product. I tried to make it as similar as possible. I placed this at the very top of the screen. Next, we need a section that shows information about PM2.5. I created an object called PM panel and placed all related objects under it. The size of this panel is 320 by 160 and is located just below the top image. Next, I created a label that says PM2.5. Here, the font is Arial and the size is 25. Please refer to the previous video regarding custom fonts. We also need a label that actually reflects the value. This shows only numeric information, so the segment font contains only numbers. You can see three rounded squares on the right side. This part functions to display the status according to the value of PM2.5. It's classified as good, normal, bad, and the cursor image moves up and down to indicate the status. When I created this cursor, I thought about how to move two cursors at once. My decision was to create an image with two cursors image and move it. Since I need to add animation, I thought it would be better to make it a single object. The following section shows the surrounding temperature and humidity. Here too, I created a temp panel and placed all relevant objects inside it. The unit of temperature is a Fahrenheit, so F is included. Place the label to display the temperature data you will get from the sensor. Additionally, the temperature icon is also placed on the left. Humidity was also worked in the same way. The last panel is about TVOC. And there is a TVOC label, and the arrow rotates according to the TVOC index. I added an animation that keeps the arrow rotating because it is not currently connected to the sensor. This is just dummy code. That's it for this UI. If you are not familiar with creating UI, it can be difficult. I know. At first, I didn't know anything either. That's why I'm making this tutorial video. But isn't it fun? As a developer, I found it very fun to do design-related coding like this. In the next project, we will see how to update the screen with data obtained from the sensor module. I hope this helps your project. Alright, thanks so much. See you on the next project.